come from Earth, a planet of outlaws.
My name is Peter Quill.
There's one other name you might know me by.
Star-Lord.
Who?
Well, Star-Lord, man. Legendary outlaw.
Guys?
Forget it.
How exciting Whoa! Is that? I know. That is a look at the newest Marvel movie, Guardians of the Galaxy. We happen to have one of the stars here with us right now, who just happens to be a multi-Oscar nominated actor, no big deal. Welcome the very handsome, very sweet Djimon Hounsou. Welcome to our show.
Thank you
for being here. We just saw a really cool clip from the movie, and the character you play, this is unlike any character you've played before. Usually you get to be the good guy, right? But this time you're the villain with the scary eyes, and just, it's crazy. What was it like playing Korath the Pursuer?
It was exciting. I play the character of Korath the Pursuer, who's dedicated to terminating his subject once targeted. But this is an amazing sort of like an action-adventure, epic space drama.
But yet there's some humor.
I know, I love
it. Great, great amount of humor. And this was like, I think this was a great job done by our director, James Gunn, keeping the story somewhat organic, but and adding, making sure that you have fun, you have a bit of laugh.
Well, anytime you have an animated raccoon, is it a raccoon?
Yeah.
I mean, you gotta have fun with that, right?
Is that Bradley Cooper? That's Bradley Cooper.
Yeah, indeed.
How funny.
Yes, indeed.
So we have a lot of clips because everybody's so excited about this movie. Let's take a look and see you in action as Korath.
Yes.
Take a look.
Drop it.
Hey.
Adar Silikala, drop it now!
Hey, cool man, no problem. No problem at all.
How do you know about this?
I don't even know what that is. I'm just a junker, man. I was just checking stuff out.
You don't look like a junker. You're wearing Ravager Garb.
It's just an outfit, man. Ninja Turtle, you better stop poking me.
What is your name?
My name is Peter Quill, okay? Dude, chill out.
Move!
Why?
Ronan may have questions for you.
You're so scary!
Freaking out here. So how much freedom did you have playing that
character? Because there's not much written about him in the comic books, right? So you kind of have to imagine
him bringing the life yourself.
But then you have a limitless freedom to trying anything you like, and that's exactly the point that I was trying to make about James Gunn. You know, the freedom that we had in interpreting some of those characters as we see it fit.
Well, you definitely brought it.
What's the production like with movies like these? Because I know a lot of it's got to be green screen and whatnot.
Well, it is a great amount of green screen, but again, we shot this whole film in London, and we occupied two different studios. But the thing that was exciting, every day you go on set, you see different creature looking. You felt like you were on a different planet. It was a world apart.
So this is now, I think, the 10th film in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, if you will. Why do you think the superhero genre is so successful and so many people, young and old, just love it?
It's because I think we're all kids at heart. And And obviously, most of us like to forget, our daily struggles, and
Speaking of struggles, our challenge today is to stop living in the past, and I'm wondering, have you taken on that challenge for yourself?
Well, yes, I have, but again, I try not to live too much in the past, because if you don't have a history, if you don't have a past history, then you don't have anything to hang on to.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Do you see what I mean?
It defines who you are.
Yes. And then you're a little more freer. Yeah.
As a therapist, you probably love hearing that.
I do, because the reality is he just said something that was very key. It's like our past doesn't have to define us, but it can refine us.
Forget your past.
It can make us better.
Yes, indeed.
See, that's why you do what you do.
I do what I do.
Well, listen, speaking of a blast from the past, I have to say, when we heard you were coming, we know all the great movies you've done and the amazing work you've done, but most of us remembered you breaking out in this. Just had to throw it out there. Janet Jackson.
Wow.
Love Will Never Do Without You music video. We watched this. We were jamming out. What do you think when
and
you
watched it? And we watched it.
No. It's funny. I mean, I did that video so many years ago, but those were my early days of speaking English because I came to America not speaking a word.
Really?
And so, yeah, so those were my early days, and certainly I didn't have much conversation with Janet Jackson during that time.
Hey, so, you don't have to. I think the moves spoke for themselves.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Hey, quickly, I just wanted to mention, because you have a 5-year-old son. Yeah. I have a toddler. Tara has a 5 and a 7-year-old. They're all obsessed with superheroes. How does he feel having his dad in a Marvel movie?
Oh, he's thrilled. I mean, I took him to set many times while I was filming. So he loved it, yeah.
Was he scared of you, though? That's what I gotta know.
Well, How to Train Your Dragon 2 came out, a couple months ago.
My 5-year-old is obsessed with, by
right.
the way.
It's spectacular. Mm-hmm. It was a great, well-made film. But anyways, I took him to set many times when I was recording that. And so he's been anticipating, wanting to see the film. Yeah. So eventually we screened the film, the first international screening of the film. It was in Cannes. And so I took him to Cannes Film Festival. We both did the red carpet. And, for the first time, he put on a tuxedo for the first time. We had a great time.
Right. Well, you are a super guy. I got to say thank you so much for coming and spending some time with us.
Don't forget, you guys,
Guardians of the Galaxy is out in theaters today. Do not miss it.
Yes.
We'll be right back.
Mm-hmm.